Welcome back, Smile Mentor family. Today we are on our, we've tried in our PMMA, which is the temporary set for the, that is gonna closely mimic the final result of the smile design and the material, even though the material will be a little different. And so tried it in last week, it's been, or maybe a week and a half, it's been about 10 days. And now we're here for the follow-up to see what's adjusted. You might want to watch that video because Dr. Ratana really gives some good points on what the patient needs to look for when they get to this process, such as your bite, your look, the aesthetic. Is there any discomfort? How does the look and midline and everything with your smile and that kind of stuff? And so, you know, I took some notes and had some thoughts. And so welcome to today's episode.
Perfect.
All right.
Okay.
So, had, aside from the brightness, pretty bright. So I know, when do we get to the shade side of things where we do the final restoration? Because this doesn't help with shade, which is almost what I see first, because it's such there's contrast to my lower teeth, right? And so I see the white so strong. When do you do the shading part of this?
I mean, today we're going to do what we call the custom shade, where we're going to take pictures of your gum and this shade guide and also your teeth, okay? Mm. This type of, we call it trial PMMA, because you're going to wear it for 10 days. The material that we use to print it, to print it is like one shade, period, okay? So that's why it's very bright. Mm-hmm. But we don't care that much about this one because it's only for 10 days.
Right.
But now today is the day we're going to do the custom shade. We're going to take pictures. We're going to match everything. So if we need to do a new set with changes, now we'll do it with the shade for the finals. Mm-hmm. And then the finals, of course, we will have all the info for that.
Okay. Yeah. I think that was very wise of you, which of course that's what makes you an expert, but when you were saying don't judge how it feels right now, you need to try it out for at least a week to see how it settles and feels, because when I left out of here I thought it's really pretty funky on how it felt, but it settled in. It really did settle in some. Now I still feel my bottom teeth on the back of my top row as a little more primary than on my
the
molars,
teeth, yeah.
And this one molar is a little high, so I'm not getting even, but maybe it needs to be that way according to my teeth. But from a bite standpoint, that's what I noticed, but it was much better than when I left here. So, you know, any patients out there that are at this stage or you're about to go through it, don't get discouraged. I kind of was. I mean, I was like, okay, is this how it's gonna feel? But it really did settle in. So don't get discouraged. Give it a full week. So I'm appreciate, or 10 days, and I appreciate you saying
yes,
that.
I mean, we always do that. Why? Because the soft tissue, I mean, your cheek, your tongue, your lips, everything is used to the other position of your teeth. Mm. And in some cases, remember, we have no back teeth, for example. So as I explained it last time, cheeks and tongue will contain food so you can chew. But if you have no teeth, your tongue and your cheeks will use that empty space, and you're going to be used to that position during the 4 month or 5 months healing process of the implants. And then suddenly we put teeth back. So your tongue will try to use that space, but now you have your teeth there, so it's like you feel like trapped. Then your cheek the same, then you may bite yourself. Then your lips may be depending. Sometimes we do those changes, not in your case, but we change the position of the front teeth and you may feel different with your lips. So you can notice those little changes very easy in your mouth, but we get used to things. Okay, so if we wait 3, 4, 5 days, we get used to it. And then the other things that we need to change, we will notice at that point where is exactly what we need to change. Because sometimes it's, you say, no, but I feel like this is huge in the back. No, no, it's not huge. It's the natural shape of your teeth, but you had nothing before, so you're not used to it.
Okay.
So you wait a couple of days and you get used to that part. But then, for example, your bite. Now you just told me that your bite in the front is hitting a little bit earlier than the back. So those type of changes, we need to do those changes. But you get used to other things. You don't get used to have a bad bite, for example, but you get used to have different shapes. Mm-hmm. Okay?
Yeah. Yeah, it did make a big difference, even though I had my back teeth. It was just, you know, because I was even thinking about it on the way here. I'm going, it really has settled in a lot, except for those issues we talked about. And so it makes sense why now you guys can re-diagnose it, replan it, or not replan it, but look at what adjustments need to be made, because now it has settled in. The gums are now tightening up with the top of the ridge where that gap now has been closed. So yeah, it makes a lot of sense.
Okay, so let me check.
Okay.
That's it.
Okay. So, shoot.
Okay. Let's do the pictures for the custom shade.
We're going to do pictures for the custom shade.
Yeah, for the gum and for your teeth.
Okay, perfect. Okay.